Hey everyone, this is Kevin Shriver from Downtown Pittsburgh Dogs. Hope you all are doing very well. Thanks as always for watching. I wanted to make another video about puppies, another puppy video. I wanted to talk with all of you about the schedule, about the bathrooming habits of puppies, young puppies, when you get a new puppy in your household. I wanted to actually write all this down on the whiteboard for you, or on the flip chart for you here, because I wanted you to see and understand some of the visually see what the needs are of a young puppy, because I talk to a lot of you and I want you all to win as fast as possible with bathrooming habits. The top two reasons why dogs are given up to shelters or rehomed at a young age by families that get puppies into their household. Top two reasons: energy and bathroom habits. Energy, as in they don't figure out a way to exercise the dog, they don't set up a schedule to walk the dog, they don't work on the dog's energy, or the dog's energy does not match the energy of the home and the family's not willing to do anything about it. In particular, family's not active, they get a dog that is very, very, very active. For whatever reason, they misjudged or they miscalculated, or they just thought they were going to get a different dog. And they have some energy challenges that typically falls into some training things, as well as some exercise disciplines and routines that need to be set. Bottom line is most people just don't want to walk the dog. That's a terrible reason to give up the dog, but people do it. Bathroom habits are the other thing. The dog just never gets potty trained, never gets house trained. People just get so frustrated with cleaning up pee and poop inside of their house on a daily basis, and several times a day. They get very frustrated with that. It's a function of also, it's as we're going to talk about, it's a function of routine, also knowing your dog, but routine and getting them into a habit and a discipline is the way to go. So I want to talk about it here. First off, as always, this is the legend that you all need to follow. I say this all the time, and everybody keeps forgetting this, but you need to remember the size of the bladder that your puppy has. When your dog is 8 weeks old, which is 2 months old, which is probably the earliest anybody should be getting a puppy from a breeder or from any type of, an organization that places dogs, or, the shelters, their bladder limit is about 2 to 3 hours. 2 to 3 hours, that's all it is. They are not, you may think they're tired and they may sleep for, a couple times by themselves, but their bladder limit is getting pressed at the 2 hour limit. When they get to 3 months old, which is 12 weeks, their bladder limit is still only about 3 hours. So we're on about the 3 to 4 hour range. You could probably pick this up by now. 4 months at 16 weeks is 4 hours. 5 months, they're at 5 hours, and at 6 months, they're at about 6 hours. When they get to 7 to 8 months, that is probably the maximum length of time that they'll be able to achieve for the rest of their lives, or at least that I would suggest, as in they should be at, 6 to 8 hour range of being able to hold their bladder. Some dogs, as you know, can hold it much longer. Some can hold it shorter than that. I did a video on a weak versus a strong bladder here on the channel. If you go find that, you can hear me talk about my thoughts about a dog having a weak bladder versus a strong bladder and what that means for that time frame there. But this is generally what you need to be aware of. How this translates into walk times and walking schedules is something that everyone forgets, and they just need. I want to write this down because I want you all to see exactly what the times are. So if you have, if you live in an urban setting, a lot of my clients will target to have a long-range goal and a long-range vision of walking their dog, or having their dog walked and exercised, about 3 times a day. So they would say, this morning time slot, 7 to 8 a.m., 1 to 2 p.m., and then 8 to 9 p.m. Giving that as an example, because basically you could think of getting up in the morning, nice long walk before you go to work, middle of the day. A lot of our clients will use us to have help them out with their middle of the day dog walks. That's totally fine. Obviously, you can come home and walk your dog yourself. And then also an end of the day walk. You get your dog to like kind of the last pee. Obviously, you can take your dog out more if you choose to in between there. But this is just a general schedule for an adult dog. Again, when we're targeting 7 to 8 months. And if you've done a great job with the potty training and the bathrooming schedule in the beginning. So if you have, here's an example. What I want to write out is here's an example of a schedule for an 8-week-old puppy. People forget how much they need to go out. So if you have an 8-week-old puppy and you're taking them out at 7 a.m., you need to have another scheduled break for the dog at around 10 a.m. You're going to then have another scheduled break probably around noon, 1 to 2. Again, this might be, you might have another one scheduled at 2 p.m. You're going to have another one scheduled at 4 p.m. You're going to have another one scheduled at 6 p.m. You're getting the hang of this here. And then you might have a last pee break, I'm just going to say at 10 p.m. You may also, if you are working on slightly restricting their water, as in you're not letting them chug a whole, cup of water, at 8 o'clock or 10 p.m. or whatever, that will help increase the time that they can stay sleeping. However, you have to be very, very ready at this age, especially an 8-week-old, because they're going to wake up again. You're going to be waking up again at 5 a.m. to take the puppy out. You look at this, you might say, holy crap, I'm going to take my dog out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times in a day. Is that what you're saying, Kevin? Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying. You need to give your dog, if you want to house train, potty train your dog, you need to give it enough opportunity to know where to go and when to go. Because the dog, remember, I didn't make up this chart here. The dog has to go to the bathroom every 2 to 3 hours. It may be struggling. You may be challenging it too much to struggle. And then when you play with it, when you show it off to your friends, when somebody knocks on the door, all of those experiences happen, gets the dog excited, and it may need to go, and boom, it has an accident. We call it an accident. The dog doesn't have an accident. It has to go to the bathroom, right? One of the things I always say to people is house training and going to the bathroom is not a behavior problem. People always get upset. They're like, why are you peeing in the house? Why did you pee in my apartment? I told you we just went outside. Like, they think it's a behavior problem. It's not a behavior problem. It's a location problem. They need to go to the bathroom. They just go right there because you have not taught them where they need to go. And again, so this is where you need to build out this schedule. You are rewarding them for going out and going to the bathroom. You are going out to only go to the bathroom. Now, as your dog grows up, right, and as you start moving from, to 12 weeks, so very soon, not very long, you're going to be able to cut back to 3 to 4 hours. And, by the time your dog gets to be 4 months old, you can be doing, you may be eliminating the 5 a.m. walk. You'll be eliminating, the 12 p.m. walk here. You start eliminating walks. May still do the 10 p.m. You may eliminate the 5 a.m. I'm just running through an example of as the dog improves and you work with the dog and you start knowing that when they go outside, that's their job to go to the bathroom and go to potty outside. Very quickly, you can get to this schedule of extending. All of our clients that we work with, most of our clients that we work with who follow our schedule and take our advice, they are, again, by the time the dog gets 6 months old, this adult schedule is not out of the question. Obviously, they can take their dog out if they want to at the end when they come home from work at 5 o'clock. Dog's excited. Great. Just take it out real quick and go pee. They may do a 5 or 6 o'clock, and then they may do a 10 o'clock last pee, whatever that may be. But they have the confidence in knowing that the dog knows where to go. They are rewarded, and lots of enthusiasm is given for the dog going outside. So the dog knows exactly where they need to go. They got to that level because they were successful in managing this schedule. Don't try and push your dog too far past this. I have people do it all the time where they say, well, my puppy's really good. I think it can last till the middle of the day. And they're waiting 5 hours for a dog that should be going out every 2 hours. What that leads to is puppy gets excited. It has to go to the bathroom, you know, excited as in someone's coming in or I'm coming home. It may be quiet and tired by itself, but the moment it moves and a stimulus causes it to move, as in somebody comes into the house, guess what? The dog pees and they go, oh, it's always peeing in my house every time I come home. What am I doing? Every time I talk to people with puppies like that, they're trying to do this they're trying to stretch it out. They're either wanting to save money or they're being cheap and they're saying, oh, I don't want to pay for a dog walker. I can't pay for a dog walker, or my neighbor doesn't show up all the time. Or sometimes I get stuck at work and I can't come home, and residency and all this stuff and all these things happen. And, you know, my boss and my meetings, they're not consistent with the schedule. And what happens is then you end up sacrificing the development of the dog, and you're going to set a really challenging trajectory for yourself long-term if you are choosing not to be disciplined with the schedule. If, and I say this to my clients all the time, this schedule that looks disgustingly ominous and ridiculous, it doesn't exist forever. If you execute it now, if you do what you need to do in the beginning with your 8 and 12 and 16 week old puppy in terms of number of times you need to get it outside and keeping it on a routine, that will give you the freedom. That discipline in the beginning is going to give you the freedom in the future and for the rest of the dog's life, so that you can do what you want to do, you can play with the schedule a little bit, and the dog understands and is flexible with your life and as you continue to grow. Again, if you're not disciplined in the beginning and you just do random stuff and you say, oh, it's just peeing, it's just a puppy, and you just, you know, let it off the hook and you don't give it a schedule, you're going to be living in that, you're going to be living with that the rest of your life, and that's painful. And again, that's why, one of the reasons why people rehome dogs or give up dogs that they bring into their household, because they chose not to be disciplined, and again, it ends up affecting the dog, and that's not the best way to go. If you guys have any questions or comments about this scheduling, seeing this visual schedule, please leave it in the comments below. Always remember the chart here. There isn't magic to this. If any of you are watching this and you live in the Pittsburgh area and you would like kind of an internal or personal assessment for your puppy and your schedule, send me a message and we'd be happy to meet with you. If you need us to help fill in the gaps, this is where dog walkers come in. You do not have to do all of this. If you choose not to do all of this, but you want to execute all this, yes, you will have to invest in a dog walker for your dog. But as I just used the word investment, you are going to invest in your dog's future so that you can quickly get them to a nice, healthy adult lifestyle where they're balanced. You're not struggling to get home and see them, and you're not worried about them. And you can actually enjoy being with your dog rather than coming home and being like, oh no, you peed again, you know, at the end of your workday. I want you to enjoy the relationship with your dog, and getting them on a disciplined schedule in the beginning is the way to go. Again, this is Kevin Shriver from Downtown Pittsburgh Dogs. Thanks as always for watching. Have a great rest of the day.